I am Rajeshri Venkatramanan. Now I am giving you 120 words English shorthand dictation. Please subscribe, add public comments, like and share, and press the bell button. Thank you. Okay, we can start. Gentlemen, I have great pleasure in welcoming you to this 16th annual general meeting of your company. The report of the directors incorporating the salient features of our performance during the year under review, together with the audited statements of accounts for the year ended 31st July 1975, have already been in your hands for some time. With your permission, I will take them as read. I now invite your attention to certain significant events that have occurred and a few important developments that have taken place in the country since our last meeting. Our national economy, to begin with, had to struggle through and face damaging droughts, furious floods, persistent power shortage, chronic labor unrest, and a number of other crippling constraints. Consequently, there was a progressive decline in production, emergence of shortages, and skyrocketing of price. Inflation also set it on an unprecedented scale, while the economic situation was showing signs of getting out of hand. Threats even to our political stability simultaneously developed on the national horizon. It was at this critical juncture in our history that the central government, under the dynamic leadership of our Prime Minister, adopted and implemented a series of unrelenting and unsparing remedial measures, which, it would not be an exaggeration to say, saved the country from political chaos and economic disaster. With the promulgation of the emergency, we have witnessed a steady downward trend in inflation and a state of industrial peace seldom experienced during the last two decades, leading to a visible increase in production and all-round economic well-being. As for our own sphere of business activity, I am happy to report that your company has once again made a satisfactory profit of rupees 20 lakhs after providing for operational expenses and depreciation. Particularly in the context of certain adverse factors, the overall performance of the company has been commendable. This will be evident when I refer to the working of our various subsidiaries units during the past year. The performance of this subsidiary has been encouraging. The accumulated business crossed 71 crores as compared to 61 crores in the previous year. This achievement is all the more creditable when viewed in the light of certain misconceptions that exist regarding this indigenous, ancient and corporational financial situation, which originated in Kerala and which predates the modern banking system. It caters for the saving instincts and borrowing needs predominantly of low and middle income groups. The misunderstanding about the chit funds could be attributed to two main factors. Firstly, the ignorance of insufficient knowledge of this unique financial institution, and secondly, its promotion by individuals or companies lacking the requisite skill and or the basis crippled for efficiently and honestly running this type of business. I would, however, like to sound a word of caution here. Hotel industry in our country is inextricably linked up with tourism, covering both foreign and indigenous fields. It would therefore follow that the development of tourism based on a national coordinated plan would provide immediate incentives for the expansion of and improvements in hotelering. We gratefully acknowledge that a great deal has already been done for tourism under the able guidance of our Central Cabinet Minister, Honorary Sri Raj Bahadur, who has been associated with the portfolio for quite some time.